SolGold is an AIM-listed, Brisbane-based gold and copper explorer, and we're joined now at Mines and Money by its executive director, Nick Mather. You've just today, and in fact over the last couple of days, been making some quite significant technical announcements about your project in Ecuador. Why are these so significant?
Nigel, the importance of the recent announcements that we've made is that we are using some very sophisticated understandings about porphyry systems, sophisticated geophysical exploration techniques, and we felt that we needed to explain them in some detail to the market. We have, in relation to the details about the assays received for hole 9, now realised that there's an important change of focus that we're just starting to make in respect of our exploration strategy at Cascabel. We can now see in holes 9 and hole 5 that there is some very high-grade ore here, and that's what we're going to focus on. That's going to enable us to deliver a set of achievable commercial objectives for a lot less money and a lot quicker, with a lot less in terms of capital development requirements, and that's going to be good for our shareholders. And seeing I'm a heavy invested shareholder, that's why we're doing it.
Well, so this is, in a sense, it represents a change of strategy, because you looked at the numbers and thought, actually, we've got something very different to what we expected. What exactly are these two reports out this week showing?
The hole 9 drilling assay reports for the section between 650 and 810 metres shows a 160 metre intersection of some very high grade mineralisation. We now realise that the high grade mineralisation that we found in hole 5 was not a one-shot wonder. There is a very significant zone of high grade mineralisation that exists at least between hole 5 and hole 9. We believe that it's going to extend further towards the very impressive geophysical target that we have outlined at northwest Alpala, and we call that T1. Now, we are finding a very strong correlation between magnetic signatures and copper and gold grades, and the sophisticated modelling that we've done on the geophysical data and the conductivity work that we've done that shows that the magnetic material is also mineralised with sulphide minerals, copper sulphide minerals, is enabling us to now become very accurate and very predictive in terms of where we're going to put our drill hole. So the program that we envisage over the next year will be quicker, more accurate, and it'll cost us less money to define a high-grade resource at Cascabel.
And what are the main stages of that timetable going forward?
We'll be drilling holes regularly over the next year. We will ultimately aim to increase the number of drilling rigs on the project. We are, of course, like all explorers, frustrated by our low share price. That's something that we'll repair ultimately, and we'll be able to raise more money and get on with the job of getting the holes drilled. So we expect over the next year to get between 6 and 8 new holes drilled with the one rig that we have there at the moment. Very efficient driller, we're very happy with him. We're getting holes drilled down to as deep as 1,800 metres, and we're targeting this one in hole 9 even deeper than that. This system has some very deep roots, and happily we're finding that these deep, intensely mineralised roots are also very rich in copper and gold.
So the geology's in place, you've got the exploration potential there, but what about the geopolitics? Ecuador is, some might suggest, in political terms, a challenging place to be.
Well, we like to be involved in countries, I call them yellow light countries. That means they're going from red to green. The governments are putting a lot of effort into making them places that are attractive for foreign investment, and particularly mining investment. Mining is a great way for a poor nation to become a rich one, and President Rafael Correa realises that. He's a US economic rationalist, and he understands that mining is not dirty, but poverty is, and he wants to lift his country out of poverty, and he's putting some serious work into fixing up the mining and tax laws in Ecuador, and we hope to be riding along with the development of that much more sophisticated mining environment in Ecuador.
Also, some new developments in Fruta del Norte. Tell me about those.
Fruta del Norte is a very large gold project that was owned by Kinross, a Canadian gold exploration and mining company based in Canada. And it's recently been sold by Kinross to the Lundin family, who are one of the world's great resource entrepreneurs. And we're very heartened by that deal. They've raised $247 million to turn Fruta del Norte into a mining project, and it's a tremendous endorsement of where Rafael Correa is taking Ecuador, and a tremendous endorsement of the fact that he's going to be fixing up the mining environment in Ecuador.
So in terms of Ecuador and the geological and the political outlook, it's all looking very positive. But what about the more general outlook? You know, and people here are a bit gloomy about an awful lot of things. You know, what's your position?
Well, my position is that I'm very much an opportunist, and it's always darkest before the dawn. And I graze cattle in Australia as one of my other activities, and I'm continually talking to my manager about how we don't have any rain. He says, "Nick, don't worry about it. Every day that goes by, we're a day closer to it raining." So the same applies to financial markets and economic cycles. And I think every day that goes by, we're getting closer to a recovery. And personally, I don't think it's too far away. We have 4 billion people urbanising throughout the world over the next 35, and that's going to create a lot of demand for copper and some other very key metals. And of course, we like the demand for copper. It's going to push the copper price up. And from a short-term point of view, we're going to have a high-grade resource within a year, in my view. And that's going to very much underscore a revaluation of this company.
Right. Nick Mather, the Executive Director of SolGold, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you very much, Nigel.